At this time, we will have the Dean of the Ontario School, Dr. Joe Williams, announce our guests, acknowledge our guests and visitors.
I want to thank everyone for coming out tonight and studying with us. We appreciate the Oak Branch to actually take the time out to come and visit the Ontario branch. Many members have passed through over the years, but this is the first time you, as a group, made a decision to come collectively and study with us. And I want to let you know that we're just eternally grateful that you came out and studied with us. I'm not sure if everyone signed together, but if you have, we appreciate it. But for those of you who don't know, I'd like to introduce the Dean of the Oakland Branch, Dr. Lewis Watson, and his students who come visit with us. Please stand, please. Also, I'd like to also acknowledge the Pomona branch, Shannon and Melissa Robinson from the Pomona branch. I'd like to also acknowledge you. Please stand up, please. And I'd like to also acknowledge a good old friend, Joyce
Benjamin,
who has been truant from the Ontario class for at least 5 or 6 years. I appreciate you coming down and studying with us. And also, I want to also acknowledge my friend, Rip Macklin. He's international. I'm not exactly sure where he stands, but appreciate him coming down. And I also want to acknowledge our moderator. He's loyal to just Yahshua the Messiah, but he goes to Pomona, and he also comes to Ontario. I'm comfortable with it, but I want to acknowledge our moderator, Dr. Reggie. So at this point in time, I'm going to turn everything back over to the moderator.
We're going to have a three-speaker format this evening, and sometime in there we're going to take a 15-minute break, too. So our first speaker this evening will be the Dean of the Ontario School, Dr. Lewis Watson.
Oakland.
I wanted to see if y'all was awake. Oh, good evening, everyone. I'm overjoyed and happy to be here with your fellows today. It's been a while. I've been here many times before, way back, and continuously as Dr. Joe Williams had already said, but collectively as a part of our school, it's now all our school. We decided that we want to come and visit Ontario. Reason being is because we always want to be in company with those that are preaching the true gospel of Yahshua the Messiah. And that's what we do, and that's what we are coming together for, is to sup with our brothers. And as you all know, this is a result. I don't have anything new to tell you this morning, this afternoon. But it might be new for some, because that's why we repeat things over and over again. Because nevertheless, you might have heard it, you might know it, but the other people might not have heard the things that are being spoken. Because the true speaker is not the vessel that you see per se.
Right.
That's standing before you. And we have to be able to explain that also. When you tell somebody the speaker is not the one you see standing before you, but what you talking about, Lewis? So that has to be explained. Just as everything else in the school has to be explained. And this is a school, it's not a church.
Right.
And when you come to this school, you expect to hear something that you have not heard before. coming into this school. I'll put it that way. Now, the things that you see on the wall, the drawings and the charts, they were given to a man called Henry Clifford Kinley in the year 1931. And he received a stupendous vision. And he also received a revelation of the things that you see pictorially illustrated on these charts. And I know that everybody that's looking at these charts do not understand everything that's on these charts. But this man that I'm talking about, everything that he put on these charts, he knew and understood what it was that he put on these charts. And if you want to know anything about somebody, who do you go to? You go to the one that you want to know something about. And we come down here, we say we want to know something about our Heavenly Father. And our Heavenly Father's name is Yahweh. We did not too long knew that with our Heavenly Father's name. And had not it been for a man called Henry C. Kelly, we would have known that. Although we've been in this world all these years, for myself, I've been in the world almost 80 years. And I didn't know the name of the true, the Heavenly Father was Yahweh until 1975. But my mother went to church, my father went to church. No, I can't say that. My father did not go to church. And I didn't go up until the time I was about 14. Then I didn't go anymore. But I never knew that the Creator had a name. He always called him Lord, God, or Jesus Christ. And even back then, they weren't using Jehovah that much. So everything we learn about our Heavenly Father, and you can attest to this yourself, you learned it from this school and from the man that had, that said he had this divine vision and revelation. And the reason why I said he said he had that is because later on down the line, he explained to us that I am the vision.
Right.
So I took that and I listened to it and I said, that's right. Because if he's who he said he is, then he would be the Alpha and the Omega also. That means the beginning and the ending of his purpose. Now these charts that you have on this wall, I don't know where I'm going. I'm just going to follow whatever Yahweh gives me to say at this moment. Now, what you see on these charts, you have on this chart right here, which one I like, it says beginning and ending. Now, you look at that and you say, well, something starts and something ends. And then you read on the top of the chart, it says the creation abides within Yahweh or eternity. We read the vision in our school. It says the creation abides within Yahweh or eternity. Then you do a little minor investigation and you find out that eternity has no beginning and it has no ending. So why do you have beginning and ending laid out on this chart? I'm just going to say a few things. Now, it's been stated that you have to know the purpose of Yahweh in order for you to be saved, right? I don't know whether you heard it or not, but it's all over the system. And you and I know for the surety that we all do not speak the same thing.
That's right.
From the school. At one time we did.
That's right.
But now it's not like that. And reason being is because Yahweh has purpose for that to happen.
That's right.
He even wrote it in the book.
That's right.
There you go.
So the things that are in the book, you read out of the book, people say, I believe the Bible. Then you go in there and read something, and They said, I don't believe that. Yeah, it actually happens, you know? So now getting back to what the moderator was stating, he said that Yahweh is spirit, right?
Right.
And he is symbolized on this chart by this cloud. Didn't say that he was a cloud, but he used the cloud to symbolize spirit. Now, spirit has no particular shape or form. And you cannot discern it with your natural eyes at no time. Is that right? And he also said that this cloud goes all around the edges of this chart. And I know you heard these things before. You look on the chart, you see the sun in the sky, you see stars, right? You see mountains, you see hills, you see people, right? And it tells you that this cloud, which is Yahweh, goes all around the chart. Now this man came to us and told us what that meant. No preacher in the world was able to tell you what that meant.
Right.
But it's right there in the Bible. And guess what? It's right here on this chart. Acts 17 and 28. Please read it. I'm just going to do some simple things today. And I have a point. And when I get through, I'll sit down. Please read.
Acts
17 and 30. That's the start here. 27? Don't worry about it. We're in my bed. As the dean said, this is his building. We can stay here as long as we want to. Right? Okay, read.
Acts chapter 17, verse 20. For thou bringest certain strange things to our ears. We would know, therefore, what these things mean.
28.
28. Acts chapter 17, verse 28. For in him we live.
Okay.
And move.
Oh.
And have our being.
Oh. You got it right now. Now, we would have never known what that meant in that Bible about we live and we have our being. Read.
For in him we live and move and have our beings, and our of our your own poets have said, for we are also his offspring.
We are the offspring of the Creator himself.
That's right. That's correct.
That's what your books say. Mm-hmm. Then you have some that say, I don't believe that. That's not so. I'll just leave that right there.
Mm.
Okay? Now, he said that Yahweh is symbolized by this cloud. Now on this chart here, this is the same cloud. It goes all around the edges of this chart. Is that right?
Right.
Now it says Alpha, beginning, and Omega. Do I have that backwards?
That's right.
You guys are scholars, you know, right? So that's what it means, beginning and ending. Is that right?
Right.
Now you have another scripture right up here, Proverbs 8 and 22. So let's see if that fits. Remember, there's a man that put these charts up here, and he went and put scriptures out of the Bible. The Bible was already in existence before the vision even came. Is that right? But nobody was able to put these things together that you and I know right today. Right? We're talking about who's the beginning and who's the end. We're talking about who was Henry C. Kelly. That's what we're really talking about. Okay? Now go on and read that, please. 8 and 22.
Proverbs chapter 8, verse 22.
Mm-hmm.
Yahweh possessed me in the beginning.
Now Yahweh possessed who and what in the beginning of what? Now when you go to Genesis 1 and 1, it tells you in the beginning. Now you should say in the beginning of what? Right? That's another beginning, is that right? But here's the beginning right here, is that right? So now what he has told us is what is not being taught today, whether or not Yahweh, Elohim, was always in shape or form. And you can prove it by the Bible.
See?
Right?
That's right.
And he told us to stay in the confines of the Bible.
That's right. Right.
And we can do these things. Right? Mm-hmm. Now, read.
Yahweh possessed me in the beginning of his way.
Possess who? Well, read on.
Before his works of old.
Before his works of old, read on.
I was set up from the everlasting.
So that's the beginning of something. Mm-hmm. Right? So he's possessed something that's set up from the beginning. So here we are. In the beginning, is that right?
That's right.
And here we are. In the beginning. Talking about these attributes. Mm-hmm. Is that right? Mm-hmm. That's what was in the beginning,
right.
That was set up,
right,
to do something. Is that right?
That's right.
Read. That's right. Go ahead.
From the beginning, or the earth ever was.
Before the earth even came into existence, he was set up.
That's right.
Here. Read.
When there was no depths, I was brought forth.
No depths. You know how we go out to the ocean and we see the water come up? Mm-hmm. We can stand right there. The water come right up to the end of our feet. Mm-hmm. They won't come no further. They go right back out. Mm-hmm. I think that's a little bit of power on it. Mm-hmm. Right? Real.
When there were no fountains abounding with water.
Mm-hmm.
Before the mountains were settled.
Mm-hmm.
Before the hills was I brought forth.
Mm-hmm. I was brought forth.
That's right.
I'm reading in the Bible. Mm-hmm. Do you believe it?
Right.
Right? I just said that you read out of the Bible. People say, I believe the Bible. Then when you read something in the Bible, they tell you, I don't believe that. But he was not always in shape and form. He was set up.
That's right.
Right? And that's Yahweh taking on a discernible shape and form. You read it right there in Proverbs 8 and 22.
That's right.
That's where you're reading it at. And to validate that, since John on the Isle of Patmos has to go all the way back, and we read a little bit about him in the beginning, right, of class in Revelations, he's going to tell you something about it. In Revelations 3 and 17. I do believe that's what it is, right? I'm not really good at scriptures, but I know what's in the book. And I'm just going to say a few things, and I'm going to sit down. Whatever it is that Yahweh let me say. I'm not allowed to say too many things.
Feel free, bro.
But it's okay. You know, me and my wife been around in 37, 38, I don't know how many years. And we run the gamut around here. Read, please.
Revelation 3:17.
14.
And unto the messenger of the assembly of the Laodiceans write, these things saith the I Am.
I will be.
The faith.
Right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Not I am, but I will be. Not I am that I am, as it's written in Exodus, right? And who corrected that? See? I will be what I will to be. And that's who's speaking right now. Read.
The faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation.
The faithful and true witness. Now, who is the faithful and true witness? Now, if it's a witness, that means an eyewitness is what?
Right.
An apostle. Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. Now, he's a true eyewitness. Is that right?
Right.
And you just read about him in Proverbs 8 chapter. He's the true witness in the beginning. But nobody else there. Just like when Moses wrote. Who was there with Moses when Moses was right there? No. Moses wasn't even there. Right? But all these things we didn't know prior to coming to this school. We got something here. We got something we can prove and validate. And something that we want to know, because the first aim of our school is what?
To help you find and know Yahweh.
No, to help you find and know Job.
No.
See? That's what we come down here for. To know our Heavenly Father as He really is and as He actually exists. And some of us have obtained that.
That's right.
To know Him as He really is and actually exists. Right?
Right.
Now, what we're trying to show right now, briefly, is how this came about. Read on.
I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would thou wert cold or hot.
Mm-hmm.
So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold
nor
hot.
Is that what I want? I want 314? Okay, read on.
King James.
Yes. Thank you so much. I forgot. I didn't even mention that. We were told to get a good King James Schofield Bible, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the only reason we use the Holy Name Bible is because Yahweh made a man by the name of A.B. Train,
mm-hmm.
put the true names in the book. That's why we use the Holy Name Bible. But if you want a good understanding of the Bible, get a good King James Schofield Bible.
Yeah.
All the scriptures on these charts is from the King James Schofield Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, read this.
Revelation chapter 3, verse 14, King James Version. And unto the angel of the church of the Laodicea,
mm-hmm.
right?
Read fast, please, sir. I don't know how much time I got.
These things said the Amen, the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of God.
Mm-hmm.
And know thou works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I would thou wert cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art rich and miserable and poor and blind and naked. I counsel thee to buy of me gold tried in fire.
What I'm looking for, I want to get direct to the point, is this is the beginning of the creation of Yahweh. That's what I want.
26.
I don't want to get too far off track. Because what we're talking about is Proverbs 8:22.
Uh-huh.
You see, and now we're hooking it up with Revelations, with John saw in his vision.
That's verse 14.
Right? Mm-hmm. Okay, read.
Chapter 3, verse 14. And unto the angel of the church of the Laodiceans write, these things say Amen. The faithful.
I will be.
King James.
Go ahead, read.
The faithful and true witness,
uh-huh.
the beginning of the creation
the
of God.
The beginning. See that?
Uh-huh.
The beginning. Beginning. Is that right? Now all these things is on your chart, right? The beginning of what? Creation.
The beginning of the creation of God.
What's this say? Founding of the universe, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Now what does this say?
Creation.
The creation by the archetype original pattern of the universe. Is that right? And with the archetype original is this one.
Right.
Is that right?
That's correct.
So everything in the universe is patterned or have to be patterned after Yahweh Yahweh.
Right.
Now that's what we learned down here in the school. Just like that. You can learn that nowhere else.
Nope. See?
Is that right? Nowhere. Now, that's enough. Going back to this, you come down here to the school, and we got a word across this chart. Mm-hmm. It says dispensation.
Right.
Now, what does that mean? This is a school, right?
Yeah.
So what did Yahweh do? He inspired Webster to put, that's what happened. To put in the dictionary what a dispensation is. And you don't hear the Reverend down the street talking about dispensation.
Right, right.
Now we're going to back this up with Ephesians 1 and 9. Right? But read what a dispensation is.
The definition of dispensation, a general state or ordering of things.
A general state or ordering of things. Read on.
A system of revealed commands
and
promises.
A system of revealed
commands and promises regulating human affairs.
And promises. Hold on. I think this is a promise.
There you go.
Right?
Yes.
This is a promise. Now when you go and you read Genesis 12 chapter, you find out that the promise said he would bless them that bless you and curse them that curse you. That's a promise.
See?
Right?
Right.
Read on.
A particular arrangement or provision.
A particular arrangement. Now we're going to arrange all this here, here, and here. That's an arrangement.
Yes.
Right? Laid down in eternity.
Right.
Right? Which has no beginning and no ending. Is that right?
Right.
So what Yahweh did, he placed time in eternity, right?
Right.
And he put it in dispensations and ages. Is that right? See, we're talking about knowing what Yahweh is doing.
Right. Yeah.
Reverend can't tell you that, right? Come on, read.
A particular arrangement or provision, especially of providence or nature.
Mm-hmm.
An exemption from a law or from an epidemic, vow or oath. A formal authorization. The act of dispensing. Something dispensed or distributed.
Right. Read on.
That's it.
That's it? Well, another dictionary says, by God.
Mm-hmm.
Some of you have read that, right?
Mm-hmm.
You see? And by God. That's what a dispensation is, right?
Right.
Now let's read Ephesians 1 and 9.
Ephesians 1 and 9, having made known unto us the mystery of
having made known unto us who?
Us.
Ain't wasn't no saint, was it?
Nope.
See, we didn't know that either. But John says we are the sons. That's in the Bible. Pope says saints. So he don't believe what's in the Bible. Right? But now he's writing. I think Paul is penning this, right? And he's saying, having made known unto us. Right? Read.
The mystery of his will.
The mystery of his will or purpose. Right? Mm-hmm. We have to know the purpose. Right? That's why we get caught up about what I'm doing or what she's doing or the other guy's doing, because we ain't in tune with the purpose of what Yahweh is doing.
Right, man.
Because he's doing everything, right?
Right?
So we say all the time, Yahweh doing it. And if Yahweh doing it, why are you talking unto me? Talking quiet in here. Read on.
According to his good pleasure.
According to his, it's his pleasure that he's doing it. Read.
Which he hath purposed in himself.
And he has purposed right within. Right within himself.
Very good.
All this was done right within himself. Mm-hmm. Don't it say that creation abides within Yahweh? I think that's just about himself.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. Read on.
That in the dispensation.
That in the dispensation. So now he's bringing it on down a little closer. Mm-hmm. That in the dispensation. And you say, when was that? He's going to tell you.
Of the fullness of time.
And the fullness of T-I-M-E, what happened?
He might gather together.
He's going to gather everybody together.
In one.
Now wait a minute. He's going to gather everybody in one. Now what one is that? I think that's what it is. Is that right?
That's right.
Read on.
All things in the Messiah.
Something.
All things.
All things in the Messiah. Read. Mm-hmm.
Both which are in heaven.
Now he's not leaving out the angelic creatures either. Right. Is that right?
That's right.
Those things that are in, where you think heaven is? Where you think hell is? Well, I know what I thought. That's heaven. Devil's down there. Is that right? These things are funny now.
Yeah.
But prior to coming into school, before this man told us, we didn't know squat.
That's right.
About nothing. Is that right?
That's right.
But now he's gathering together all in one, those in heaven and in hell too. Read on.
And which are on earth, even in him. In whom also we have obtained an inheritance.
And we have an obtained an inheritance, right? We have an inheritance. Choir sings a song in the California state, we have an inheritance. And get your inheritance. Is that right? Because we do have an inheritance, right? Now, when you want to have an inheritance, you like to know what the inheritance is, what it is that you have inherited. Right? Read on a little bit more.
Being predestinated according to the purpose of.
And it was predestinated according to what?
The purpose of him.
So that means it was done all back here. Is that right? The same thing with you and me. If you wanted to be a different color or have different eyes and all that stuff, you'd have to go back up in here and change it. Is that right? Too late when it came down here. Is that right? Because it was purpose back here for it to happen. Is that right? Now, to make this short, quick, since I got 5 minutes, Yahweh wrote something on each one at the end of these ages.
That's right.
1 Corinthians 10 and 11. Look at me, please, and don't look at me, but look at where I'm pointing. Down here, he wrote 1 Corinthians 10 and 11 again. And you see that's the end of an age, which is approximately 2,000 years long. And it's a lot of stuff going on in here. Is that right? And it's all in your Bible. It's a lot of stuff. Is that right? Now, at the end of these ages, and this is surely the end of an age, I don't have time to get into it yet, right now. But this was an end, and this is an end, and this is an end currently coming.
That's right.
Is that right? Mm-hmm. And we know that the chronologies is 33 years off.
Right.
We know that, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
So this is not 2012.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right.
You understand?
That's correct.
Mm-hmm. And we'll get into that if you want to. But now, on this end of this age, he wrote another scripture, 2 Thessalonians 1 and 6. So I want you to read both of them, because one goes here and one goes here. Is that right? I'm talking about what Yahweh has done, not me, not you, not the Sanhedrin Council, or what you call up there in L.A. But Yahweh did this. Is that right?
Right.
And it's put the aims in force to help you find and know me as I really am and actually exist. He did that. Is that right? And he would be unjust to do this to you if he don't give you a way to know.
That's right.
Is that right? So that means he did. Is that right? Read, please.
1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 28.
No, 11.
11.
10 and 11. Come on now.
Chapter 10, verse 11.
Right.
Now all these things happen unto them.
Now your question should be, all these things what? What things? Happen to what? Read on.
Unto them as a warning to us.
As a warning to, now who's to us? And what's the warning for? That's question, ain't it?
Mm-hmm.
Read on.
And they are written for our instruction.
Our instructions. You know what instruction is? I'm going to show you, do this way, don't do it that way. You're getting instructions, is that right, on what to do and what not to do? Right? Read on.
Upon whom the end of the age is
on
come.
On whom the end of the age has come. Ain't that the end? Don't do that. Now, same thing here. Don't do that. Is that right? Now, read what he said at the end of this age. After he done give you 6,000 years to know him as he really is and actually exists. Read that. How many more minutes I got? One?
Seeing it is a righteous thing with Yahweh
mm-hmm.
to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you.
And you sure got trouble. I know I got trouble.
And to you who are troubled, rest with us.
Mm-hmm.
When Yahshua the Messiah shall be revealed from heaven
right.
with his mighty angels. Mm-hmm. In flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know
that
not Yahweh.
Know them that know not. Yahweh.
That's right.
Why did they don't know it? Because they refuse or reject knowledge. That's in the book. Is that right? And he's giving you the way to know him. Is that right? So now he's taking flaming vengeance on us that do not know him. Read on.
And that obey not the gospel.
And do not obey the gospel. Read on.
Of our Savior, Yahshua the Messiah.
What else?
Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of Yahweh
mm-hmm.
and from the glory of his
you see,
power.
You know what happened here? When the veil went up? Adam mm-hmm. was no longer in the presence of Yahweh.
Right.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's a sad state to be. Right? Read on. Come on.
Who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of Yahweh and from the glory of his power, when he shall come to be glorified in his Son.
Come to be glorified in you and in me.
No.
Is that right? Well, that's we're his sons, ain't we?
Right.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean, no? Ooh, goodness. Read on.
And to be admired in all them that believe, because our testimony among you was believed in that day. Wherefore also we pray always for you, that our Elohim would count you worthy of this calling, and fulfill all good pleasure of his goodness, and the work of faith with power.
And many are called, but few are chosen. Why is that? Because only a few is going to be obedient. Is my time up?
Yes.
Okay.